Okay. I'm trying to think of a joke and I can't.
Also been muted
But
this whole
you
time.
got it. I mean, you got to play to win, so.
I just realized that I've been muted this
You're
whole time.
Oh.
Yeah, you've been able to be heard, but I've been muted.
Oh, I've actually done that before, so
Yeah. New
don't feel
setup.
too
I've
bad.
got a new setup going on. You normally have like a two computer setup going on for streaming.
Okay.
But due to some circumstances, I currently have a one computer setup temporarily. And so yeah, the change of pace has got me
two
thrown
computer
off.
bourgeoisie.
Right?
So okay, with knowing that, just to tell everyone what you missed from this fine gentleman was saying, one, it was welcome back. This is a rescheduled match from last Wednesday. And basically RMU are already in the top three. They're already in playoffs. Eastwoods University Club, Ecole, something something in French. While they're win or lose, they're out of playoff contention, but they're here to play spoiler. Spoiler kind of sorta, because like RMU are making it through anyway. It's just what position these top three teams in this group are gonna make it through.
Yeah, the seeding is very important. Getting into the top one or two seed does get you a significantly easier matchup because if you look across the board and up just about every group, you've got the top one, maybe two teams that are all extremely close, extremely competitive, and then like it's kind of a drop off onto that third seed. So if you can, especially if you get a top seed, you know you're going to be getting one of those weaker teams as your first round matchup. That is a much easier road through the playoffs to be able to have one of those lower seeds.
Seeding is important. You hear so many pundits talk about at the professional level how important seeding is. And that's also here in collegiate. It's any sort of competition.
Well, it does look like we are getting into the knife round as we speak. So players are ready, players are in. We are going to be getting underway as it does look like it was RMU that took the knife round. So without further ado, going to hop into the game and bring all of the action as Ecole Esports University takes on Robert Morris Flying Eagles.
Yeah, it looked like okay. Yeah, RMU. The name only just now got swapped. Yeah, RMU did win, and they are on this. They chose to get select the CT side. Cash is a pretty even map. It doesn't swing really hard one way or the other. Due in part to the fact that it's mostly like it's more on the aim duel side of maps rather than a super tactical like trainer nuke. But that generally, when you say even, that's generally what like. 8-7 CT side just because of defense. What's the word? It doesn't matter. I'm gonna stop thinking because I actually have a get and ooh, a fight right here, right outside of the main where RMU actually take a 2-for-1 trade. They had three of their CTs push out, met up directly with five terrorists, and even with lesser numbers, they got the better of that trade and they back off. Also forces Esports University Club. Oh! AWOL also taking another team Britain. Heard the vent broke, all turned around just at the wrong time. Took a little bit of damage, but he was able to get out. That being said, the T's have gone behind enemy lines, and we do see what player is that? Fat Will and Etsy, or Ethelic.
Ethel.
Coming from CT into B, so the opposite side of where we usually come from.
It does just get Fat Will taken left out now.
One, yeah. One on three.
Almost takes out AWOL there, but doesn't quite hit. Does get him down, but the knife. Oh boy. Spermy with the knife kill at the end there in order to help secure the first round for RMU. Nice solid round there. They lost a couple members, but wasn't too shabby. They are gonna actually force up a little bit here on round number two.
Yeah, this is a pretty standard buy right now. Not a single rifle coming into play.
I'm surprised that Lennox's not buying anything. Oh no, he has a deagle. He has a deagle.
He's probably trying to save for an op potentially. Eastwood Junior recently did not get the plant, and so they're gonna have to save next round regardless. So they're just gonna force him to see if he can't find anything. Which is, you could argue that RMU because of that. Well, okay, no, there's two sides of the coin. RMU, they definitely made sure that in the SMGs to get UMP because it has the better armor penetration. Granted, rifles have even better armor penetration, but they don't want to potentially lose a couple of rifles to this team. And while I'm talking, Welshy gets a 2K, trying to get more, runs into the smoke, just barely gets seven. Oh no, through the smoke, actually falls. Was able to get two for himself. Lennox joining up with a third. That's Spermie also taking out Acronym, as well as the bomb, and Ethelic is spotted out. Ooh, almost takes out Boom Boom. Takes him down to 9 health with that headshot. But solid second round from RMU.
Yep, 2-0 quickly to kick things off. We'll see how well they can keep this up. As obviously, you know, get that first round, especially if you can stop the T side from planting, you're going to have a pretty solid advantage for you know, the first 3 or 4 rounds at the very least.
Yeah, and as I was saying, they didn't get a bomb plant on either round, and so Esports University Club, like, they have one T250, they have one smoke. Everyone else is completely full saving. They're hoping to run in here, get a plant on the A site. Everyone else is centered around here.
Lennox still holding on to the deagle. So almost certainly, like you said, saving up for that AWP, knowing, again, that it's going to be another save round. There's no reason for them to go spending, and Welshy with a big 3-4 spray! What a play from Welshy. He actually only got credit, I think, for 3 of them. But that was an incredible spray down right outside that door.
I mean, that was all set up just for him. He was playing the NBK spot. I honestly see it more of an FNX spot, but that's because... Well, anyway, NBK, FNX, whatever you want to call it, just around that corner, and they ran right into him. Armorless T's running into a UMP. I think in that situation, actually, UMP is even better than a rifle. Now that they actually have rifles, Mata! A nice headshot there, flanking into Sunroom. This opens it up for Eastwood Team Club, and trying to get more, get some good damage onto Spermie. So already with the man advantage. However, in mid, there is Lennox, who does not have an AWP. He actually has a rifle. Pushes up. Has a nice angle and able to drop Mata. But that is A side relatively open. Acronym takes out the lone A player right now. Gonna get the bombs down shortly. So finally get a bomb plant on the 4th round. It's a 4-3 right now. There is no AWP on the Esports University Club. But there being one on RMU does make retake slightly less comfortable. A nice boost actually going up behind quad. Has to fall away from that to get some good information. And that failed nade behind there. Actually, Fat Will does some damage to himself.
Acronym with a couple of nice kills there, but does end up falling. However, Ethelic will get the final kill of the round. So first round of the game going over to Esports Club. And they pick up the AWP at the end there. Fat Will barely grabbing that.
Yeah, that's definitely a good thing. Their economy needs that little bit of a boost just because of the lack of bomb plants for the first 3 rounds. And Mata, why are we seeing an SMG from him? I mean, you guys haven't done that much damage to RMU. They're not saving after one loss just yet, but...
And definitely a curious pickup of Acronym. Gonna be able to find Lennox there. Even though Lennox got the first shot off, Acronym still able to take him down. And now Boom Boom picking up a double for himself.
Yeah, interesting trades happening there mid. I feel like it was a little sloppy take by both teams, if I'm perfectly honest. But AWOL is chilling behind there. Behind Squeaky gets a sneaky little kill on Ethelic. Actually flashes and has to molly himself out because they know he's there. There's not a molly on esports team though, so he's a little lucky for that. Taking some damage from HE, that's unavoidable. And that is Lamoto actually getting killed with his SMG that I was just criticizing.
Spermy in a position to try and drop down on them if he can spot. Oh, nice spot there, taking out Mata. Now it is just Fat Will left to try and go and get this round victory.
Nice headshot.
Fat Will.
Good start.
Spermy just completely missed that shot.
Yeah. He also, I don't know, a little unexpected for them to push out, but I don't know if he's going to expect what well she is.
No.
Does not. He had no clue. And he was also running out of time. So, yeah. Can't really blame him too much for that.
No, not at all. Even just to get that kill onto Spermy was really nice. That definitely should have been Spermy getting that kill. He had the advantage there. He got the first shot off, but missed. And a nice turnaround headshot there from... Fat Will was able to at least make it a little bit closer.
But now because of that loss, he's supposed to be University Club on another little save force by coming down. Another spray down with UMPs. Burmy gets a double for himself. Acronym gets some good actually gets a kill on the Lennox. If he goes, oh, there's only a deagle to be picked up though. That's unfortunate.
Acronym, 1v4.
On 1 HP, can't he do
HP.
It?
This would be the clutch to send all clutches right here.
No, his best hope right now is to just get maybe one more. It doesn't matter. I was going to say, maybe he could try to find one more kill, do as much economical damage as possible, but there is.
Yeah, no.
If he made it out of that round, that's thanks to RMU letting him.
Pretty much, yeah. At that point, again, one hit point, 1v4.
No, you could throw a flash at him. He would die by getting hit in the face with a flash.
Yep. Another
so, that's happened once in like a big like
we have yet major, to right? see
we haven't seen here because it's that rare, but I think it actually has happened once in like a big giant like 500k land or something.
I was gonna say we have yet to see Equal actually have a full round yet.
It's true.
Like even after their round win they still had an SMG. Now they have an SMG on Acronym.
Yeah, wonder if that is because of economy. Yeah, it must be because they're so low. But then just running into this A site, RMU has this site down. They only lose one member doing it. And esports looked a little lost. Like they just kept trying to force it, but forcing it with the imperfect execution. And like kind of like going in like one or two at a time. And with the help of utility, RMU just hold it down. That's all. To be fair, though, that's actually kind of how... this has looked. Granted, the first seven rounds aren't the best judgment of a half. Usually it's after those first seven that you really see the teams like amp up to each other. But oh, Mata running straight into HE grenades and drops the bomb on the opposite side of the smoke.
That is absolutely not going to be good for Ecole. Well, it may not even matter where that bomb gets dropped. It definitely doesn't because RMU is just on fire right now. Again, only losing one member. And they're just going to be able to continue to buy up and equal, like, see, will they get full rifles for the first time? There we go.
There we go. Full rifles,
finally.
Op 2. Ethelic is a little, doesn't have any utility and lacks a helmet, but however, RMU going to one-up them. They have an op now. We have two.
Not only do they have two ops, but they also have the utility on those ops, whereas... Ethelic, like you said, doesn't have the helmet or any grenades.
I feel like she could have dropped a second op for Spermy. I don't know. It always kind of irks me when I see imperfect, unbalanced economy on teams. But it doesn't matter. Because Fowl actually is in an interesting boost position right now in case anyone pushes out of pushes out into A main, or at least pushes aggressively into the corner just around Forklift. That has been a spot that has kind of messed them up pushing into the A site in recent rounds. So just checking for that is good. However, Welshy pushing very aggressively out of the second path. I don't really know what that whole section is called. I'm now embarrassing myself, but the second path, like into Squeaky. Pushing way past out that and takes out Mata. Has to run back now. Gonna hold Squeaky with that op. He is kind of stuck right now, to be honest, but he does get a second kill, drops the bomb. Crossfire with Boom Boom. They go take out three more members, and Marine coming from behind does drop that op. Which is for tries to get a second. Lennox, you have an AK, Len. I guess he's trying to style on them with the Deagle. He does fall because of that hubris. But RMU losing three players do get their eighth round. Esports. This is getting the dangerous spot that, like, are they officially out of even just this game?
I mean, they're definitely looking outclassed thus far. It has been pretty dominant from RMU throughout. Losing one round in the first nine, and most of those only losing one, maybe two players. Welshy off to another solid start here. See, he's just picking up constant kill after kill. Another spray down through the door, getting that collateral.
Yeah, and Lennox even gets boosted up over the boost position, takes in a third kill for himself. And you really can't look too much into this round because it is a save round on the part of Esports University Club. But this round is being RMU playing all these rounds very similar. They're very aggressive on the CT side, but it's calculated aggression. They don't do it everywhere all at once, so you didn't really expect it. And it's making Esports University Club just feel bottled in, like they can't even leave their own spawn.
Yeah, you try multiple different approaches, and when all of them end up with the same result, it gets very, very frustrating to try and figure out what you can do in order to...
here's the Hail Mary coming in. If this doesn't work for Esports University Club, this has got to be like their final. Like, this is the final strat we were going to save, and we have to pull it out now. It's like Rock Lee dropping their weights, and Fat Will gets the opening kill. Nice. So that's something.
Nice boost kill.
It's already a good start. Very quick boost. And then even throw multiple decoys just to mess with the enemy team.
Oh, man. These are the kinds of things I love to see. Just teams pulling out these, like, completely ridiculous strats. Three ops and a ton of decoys. Just, probably causing some big confusion on the side of RMU as they try and figure out what exactly is going to be going on. They probably don't even realize that, you know, it's
three ops.
Op.
Yeah. Well, there were two decoys, so they should realize that there are at least two of them.
Yeah, I would expect they would think there's two. But that third one, that's how they get you.
Now they're taking it slow, which is good on them, because at this time, it is usually the time that RMU would have pushed someone aggressively to try and take back control if they just lost that back. Marine gets a second one with the AK. Mata pushes in and stands in the fire. And an interesting little smoke there.
Oh,
actually,
boom,
just taken
boom.
Out. They just get sprayed out through it. It's just Marine left now with his own up and gets distracted by a shoulder. Gets taken out by AWOL.
Boom Boom and Welshy with a huge play through the smoke and the molly there. End up taking down three. And now looks like RMU is going to be having a little bit of fun here. As Spermy picks up the shotgun.
Hey, don't sneeze on the XM. That's... I mean, the shotguns, they're kind of coming back into meta more or less. They're still being used as specialist weapons, of course, but... Yeah, they're not the troll weapon that they used to be. Boom Boom does get the first kill though onto Marine, and that's... And actually, I just now spotted the buy. It's good that Felt was able to pick up that AK, but a little interesting of a buy from Esports University Club. A little imbalance. I wonder if there's a little bit of miscommunication coming there. But now they're missing two players. They're gonna have to come up with something big in order to take this round away from RMU. Spurry pushes out with the XM and does get a kill.
Oh man, probably should not have gotten a kill there, but it does still end up picking it up.
Aye. Fatwell, he's looking behind him, smartly so, but he's not looking behind him in the right direction because here comes Welshy.
Well, he spotted Boom Boom though.
And it's about Boom Boom, but who can expect a double flank? Oh, Welsh doesn't even get anything done with that flank. I was expecting him
to be completely surprised. Yeah, I'm kind of sad. I moved the camera over to Welshy there, expecting that flank to come through, and then all of a sudden they're both dead.
Yeah.
Rip camera work.
Actually, and even just looking at the kills, it is 11-1, which gives a little bit of context to it. But to add up, we get a scout. I love scout. Let's see if Monica should do anything with it. It's 3 CG straight out mid. Like I said, they're acting aggressively. At this point, it's not even calculated aggression. It's just straight up styling.
And Lennox hit the first kill there.
AWOL holding down the B side by himself, being surrounded by a couple of T players. Oh well, she's actually a little bored and pushing out Sneaky. But back to the A side. AWOL gets a second spray down.
It's an awfully long spray at the legs there, but AWOL gonna finish it off with that headshot onto Fat Will.
Spray control is hard, not everyone's get right. Not even get right's get right anymore, to be honest.
Well, as we are now.
Hey, we got the triple up again!
Round 14, 12-1 in favor of RMU. Again, one-sided matchup.
Give us four. You almost got that round with three. Give us a fourth.
Aw. That's clearly the way to victory.
Boom!
I want to see him come up with, like, just five ops. Just, like, save up a round and just go five at one point. But probably not going to get far enough for that to happen.
Oh, AWOL, double spray down. Oh, has to run away. Not has to, but he decides to save his own life.
Yeah.
But again, this is the CT aggression I was talking about. You put, like, one more player on one side of the map, and the other side is going to immediately expand out and take it's like an amoeba. They take back the map control that's, like, suddenly has a void left into it. RMU are liquid. They spread to fill out a gas. They spread to fill out the space available.
I mean, liquids kind of do that too.
Okay, look, the minimap looks really weird right now. The minimap looks really weird like right now. It looks like both teams are completely swapped sides. that is the one exploited thing about RMU style in that way, is that you can move through holes that they make by they're getting the holes that you make. And doesn't get that kill on Fat Will. Interesting. That HE should do some good damage and. Oh, Fat Will, you really should have hit that shot.
Yeah, there was a couple shots there that Fat Will probably should have hit. Instead, Hillock gonna get burned out. And made nice and toasty for Welshy to pick up the kill. Now the defuse gonna come through. And 13 rounds have now gone the way of RMU.
Looking at the score lines, I expected RMU to take a victory.
Mm-hmm.
I honestly didn't expect it to be this bad, which, thinking back, probably should have, because all of Esports University Club's victories have been forfeit wins. Hey! Oh! This is a first. This is a first. You're right. This wasn't what he was saving up for. All those Deagles were saving up to this.
Oh my goodness. Oh, he had a beautiful opportunity, but he couldn't see it through the smoke. Well, finds one.
I'm just imagining Marine's reaction to that because he was so close and unseen, like a ninja with a nega. I was like, how completely unexpected, and just he's landing these headshots too. This isn't the hardest thing to land headshots.
Oh my goodness.
Lennox is this on guy, a you roll. Can tell not just the fact that this is a guy who buys a Negev on a competitive match. Like would be one to do this, but you can tell that he plays a Negev a lot in deathmatch because his spray control is actually not the worst with it.
Oh, that was.
And that's a hard weapon to get a good spray control with.
That was an incredible round to finish off the half. As they're going to start readying up for halftime. 14-1 in favor of RMU. Both teams, obviously, with a triple op and the Lennox in that last round just very clearly having a bit of fun with this one now. And again, you know, this we kind of figured this might happen because. Ecole is eliminated from playoff contention, so really they were just playing because they wanted to.
Yeah, and so yeah, that's also true. You can't get as much motivation, even as okay, I do, but not everyone gets as much motivation to win when you're just playing spoiler.
Mm-hmm.
I actually get more motivation when I'm playing spoiler.
Well, you actually, that's usually when you do see big upsets happen, because the team that is, you know, playing spoiler, they don't have anything to lose, so they just kind of do whatever, and you can't really expect, you don't really know what to expect. As that's going to be Lennox now picking up dualies.
Oh, Lennox. Mata does get the first kill, though, but then Lennox does push down, gets the kill.
Nope.
Oh, Boom actually takes it away from it.
There you go. Hey,
there
we go.
There's the kill.
A double.
Gets a second.
Double kills for the double pistols.
Are they going to expect Marine from behind? He's got to go quickly, though. Acronym does take out that Lennox. Okay, he's not walking. They know he's there. Spermie is holding
he
the right.
He still picks up another kill on shot. 6 health. Lennox, or Acronym, holding on here.
Ooh, but Spermie just jumps out into Marine's face. Picks up the USP. And drops Acronym as well. This is on map point for RMU on round 16. This
14 map points. Just gotta string together a nice little streak if you're
Fat Will was saying
CT sided map 14-1, let's do this.
Yeah. Don't worry, guys. Cash isn't no, he was saying look at that comeback. Wait for the comeback or something like that in chat. But yeah, this is also the time that when you're playing matchmaking, I'm like, don't worry, it's the CT side map. Actually, nice HE does take out Welshu, returned by another HE, double Kobe, returned Kobe, and then a little bit of lag on my part.
Yeah, I got that
long
too.
Range P90 kill, but he ends up getting it. Now Marine, the scout, trying to get more. No, Spermie does do another kill of that P90. If he wins this just off of the P90, I'm gonna be upset. It's now just
knife,
Marine
or a knife.
Or a knife. Oh, he's going for
or
the knife.
Knife.
He's going for the. Oh
no! Marine JT. The knife does still end it. Ow, and how appropriate, Lennox is the one to finish it with the knife.
Okay. After 2 scout kills, the knife does come through. He got 2 of them, but I can just imagine the panic in his head, like playing Left 4 Dead, and the last person left. All these knife-wielding people coming at you.
Wonderful finish to this match as RMU do take the victory. And again, it was as expected, but at least they got to have a little bit of fun with that one down the stretch. And so with that, this group is now finished. That is it for this group. I believe that was the last game that had to be played there. There's a few more groups that still have action to come, still have teams that have to schedule their matches and things like that, but we now know RMU, they have a chance of being top 2 in their group with this victory.
Yeah, and actually, with this, I believe this is going to be the last match of us at CSL for the regular season. We were going to have a second one today, but due to other circumstances, due to them being college students, I guess it's now we're gonna have a little bit of break before we start swinging playoffs. So wait for the news on that as far as which teams finally made it through. I'm sure there's gonna be a whole big post tweeted out just about that, like announcement on who made it through or not. Though you can always look it up on SIVO. I don't entirely know how open it is to do that research, unless you want to go through every single team and be like, this one, do math yourself. Like, that's just annoying.
Yeah, the best thing is probably just going to be to wait until it gets announced by CSL. Just follow the social platforms or check out CSCStarLeague.com or on Twitch. Obviously, you're here at CStar League 2. There's also CStar League on Twitch, which has other games like League of Legends. There's some Dota, StarCraft also gets broadcast. I don't know if that gets broadcast on 1 or 2, but there's 2 channels for CSL. Make sure you follow them both. And then, of course, on Twitter, that's going to be probably your best resource, is following at CStar League is the primary Twitter. And then every single game that CStar League covers also has its own Twitter. For CSGO, it's at Collegiate CSGO, I believe, which is like the one odd one out because most of them are like at CSL and then game, but that one is at Collegiate CSGO. So make sure you head on over to Twitter, give it a follow. You'll get your updates on what's going on with the league from there first and foremost, and we hope to see you all again shortly. But
follow us too. Don't forget that.
And follow us. Our Twitter handles are right there. There's mine right below me. Cammy D's.
I say funny
over,
stuff.
I'm trying to figure out. Yeah, that's the right direction. And but of course, we also want to give a huge shout out to the sponsors of CSL. We could not do any of this without them. Asus with providing, mm-hmm. you know, all sorts of different computer needs for you. If you need laptops, computer components, peripherals, whatever, Asus has you covered. Band, of course, for communication. It's a great gaming resource to be able to coordinate with teams and players. And, of course, Twitch.tv as well, broadcasting platform. And last but not least, viewers like you. With that, I believe we're going to go ahead and call it a night here. Mm-hmm. So, one more time, Cameron Davis, I'm Tasty Bacon. Hope you all have a great night.
Only $14.99.
Don't miss the call. Download Band. Communication made easy.
Ben, Sam, and Ken are on separate journeys to defeat the menacing vile dragon. But let's just say luck isn't on their side. If only there was a way for them to find each other and band together. Well, that's why there's Band. It's a mobile app that allows people to come together using common interests. With Band, you can find fellow gamers, chat, schedule gaming sessions, and conduct polls. Stage epic battles with friends while sharing videos and photos along the way. So try Band today. Band. Be together.